Ooh, winter's coming.
Oh, yeah. Alright, let's get on, let's warm up. Oh yeah, it's got a year. I've got the front valance and the front panel filled and in etch primer, and also seam sealed. The inside. Ooh. Change hands. The wheel arches. So that's ready for stone chipping there. So what am I doing? So we got we're over this side now. And we're just about to stick the sill on the rocker panel, the sill. And there's a really obvious little rascal going on. If you can notice, there's a taper to the gap between the door and the sill. I've done a bit of measurement with the guys' measurements that they sent me. Ooh. And I'm this is a pattern wing from pattern panel from a while back, and we're too long. There's too much metal in this distance here, so I'm going to take 5mm out and re-weld a panel on the bottom again, and then that will bring me back up. But everywhere else is looking okay. I mean, my heights are as per the measurements I've been given, so we should be okay, I think, otherwise. So not so bad this side. I don't know why, but this side of the car has been easier all the way through. Isn't that funny? Not funny, funny weird. Yeah, everything about it has been easier. Don't know. Spooky. Just sticking that new plate on the bottom. So, 6mm up from the original. Actually, let's check it. Yeah. Looking for 449, I think. Do I set it? That bit done. Just fit the seal now. Thank you. That's the seal screwed on. A bit messy with the seam sealer, but hey ho, clean off all right when it's dried out. Archie, say hello to YouTube. Go on, say hello to YouTube. No, nothing. What are you doing? So Scotty and me, Archie and me, we're here. Archie's looking to see if we could pinch anything. Here's a little bunky. I had a bearing on my sander, which was a bit of a bugger. But in the pocket here somewhere. Another bearing for £2 off the flea bay, so all good. So we'll sling that in there, and we'll be back up and running again. Getting on with the little rascal, little Vincent. You alright, Arch? Yeah, so getting there slowly. Right, back with you in a bit. Well, all I've got to try and remember is where all that lot goes. Crikey. Oh, no. Work it out, will we? Yeah. It's better. Ooh! Sound is working all right. Getting some skimmed on here, a few little tiny bits. I've got to put some stopper in, but it's just fighting myself to stop. I'm using the sander on the just the high little high bits, you know. When I like here, when I've got some lumps, it's only I'm only just taking the high bits off, and then I'm putting it down and keeping it out of the way of myself, so I don't go sanding all the filler out. but I'm just, it's just fighting myself to not sound. I mean, these here, there's you know, big spread to fill up, but it's I think there was about a thumb size little divot there and a thumb size divot there, a bit like these. That's 120 grit, and I've got a little tiny bit in 240 grit to take it, you know, just to smooth the scratches out. But they're just a bit like car park dents, you know. So that's what I was doing there. But you can see, you know, it's see-through the filler, so it's not like this. It's not like I'm doing any plastering or anything, so it's not too bad. It's just smoothing the old girl out. I've got to seal that up. Panel I made to go in there, so I need to seal that. But we're getting on slowly. Any of you rascals who watch my channel, or have watched it in the past, will know that I'm no bodywork expert by a long shot. But I just want to explain one of my little problems. If you can see that panel there, it looks like there's problems, don't it? Yeah. The problem I got is that filler is so thin now that believe it or not, the marks are showing through. Now, normally I would keep sanding until they've gone. Of course, I end up with a depression in the panel. My hands aren't the daintiest hands in the world. I've spent a lifetime working with heavy machinery, so my hands aren't as sensitive as they could be. But I've got it. You know when you've got problems with the filler, so you put a little tiny spread in there, and that's what I'm seeing. Well, it's doing my head now. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to spray it all over with some etch primer. So it'll and then sort of have a sand at that with some light paper, and then hopefully it'll what shows in will be proper problems. Does that make any sense? I know what I mean. So I've done what I'm going to do anyway. It's got the filler at the front and back of that door is from where I was, well, I think it was where I've knocked the door panel to close up the flange, so that explains that. This is pretty thin. I mean, it's this panel. This was one of those pattern panels, and it's a little bit wibbly wobbly even from new. So we'll see. I'll get some etch primer on it and then see what it looks like then. I think I've just literally just put the can down, and when you look down the panel, you know, when you do that look down the panel on when it's wet thing, it looks pretty straight, but I don't know, it's not very bright in here, that's a problem. Well, we'll see. I'll do what I said I was going to do and just put this prime on and then get some fine paper and see what's got happening then, I think. Do you reckon? Sounds like a plan, doesn't it? Anyway, that's enough mucking around for me. I started back at this at the new place, or back at the original place this week, so it gives me an extra 2 hours a day. So hopefully, if I'm not out here mucking around with this old rascal, I'll be watching people's videos again. Thanks for watching. Thanks for joining in with the shenanigans. See you later. Bye-bye.